Welcome to Daimler and the 2016 IAA commercial vehicles. Please welcome Dr. Wolfgang Bernhardt, member of the Board of Management of Daimler AG, responsible for Daimler Trucks and Buses.
Sehr verehrte Damen und Herren,
ladies and gentlemen,
willkommen
welcome to the first press conference of the 2016 commercial vehicles IAA. I hope you are well rested and ready for a firework-like display of new products. Yesterday, at our traditional pre-event evening, we showed you how we foresee the transport industry of the next decade. The urban e-truck will then be part of our big cities, just as will be our future bus and the Mercedes-Benz Vision Van. Over the next 40 minutes, we will present to you the latest innovations that you can order from us beginning this year. Before we get started, let's look at the context in which this year's IAA takes place. As for the markets, the situation remains challenging. In 2016, most countries are in reverse. This also applies to markets that are particularly important to us, such as NAFTA, Brazil, or Indonesia. There are limits to what you can do to control market development, but we hope with some growth stimulus from what will come out of this IAA for more positive market developments in the coming years. Now, as for Daimler Trucks, we have a strong market position, a very strong market position even in many regions of the world, and in this challenging environment we want to build on that. The more than 60 exhibits here in these halls make me confident. We are well positioned to do so. Now, take the first product we'll present to you this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, with it, we'll very soon make light distribution in big cities emission-free very soon. Mark Listerseer, our head of Daimler Trucks Asia, has the details for you. The stage is yours. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. At Fuso, we're taking a big step forward towards e-mobility. Today, I've brought you our most important new product, the e-Canter. It is our outlook on the series model. We've gained extensive experience with this technology. Since 2014, our electric trucks have driven more than 60,000 kilometers in everyday conditions in tests with customers. As the results of these tests clearly show, our electric counter performs convincingly in three categories. First, environmental friendliness. There are no direct emissions, and the vehicles are quiet to drive, which lessens the burden on the cities. Then, reliability. Our customers have had no problems whatsoever with the vehicles in daily use. And thirdly, efficiency. The electric counter saves up to 1,000 euros per 10,000 kilometers, which amounts to about 40% of operation costs. In addition, our customers tell us the range of 100 kilometers is more than sufficient to meet their needs for most operation scenarios. 80% of urban transport, 80% of the trucks used in urban transport are only in use for about 50 kilometers daily. Based on these findings, we developed a modular battery concept for our Fuso e-Counter. Our customers can now choose. Those who are primarily on short runs can select just four batteries and therefore get a bit more payload. Those who require a range of 100 kilometers and more can have five batteries or more installed. But finally, the answer to the most important questions: when can you buy the Fuso e-Counter? Answer: we'll deliver the first trucks to our customers by the end of next year. It will be available in Europe, in Japan and the United States. And the second important question is, how expensive will be the e-Counter? Well, there will be a premium price over comparable diesel models, but it's small enough that it can be amortized by lower operating costs to our customers in less than 3 years. To sum it all up, the technology is developed, tested, and has also become affordable. And now we are bringing it to our customers. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, electric mobility for local distribution is possible in the foreseeable future. For long-distance transport, e-mobility is not an option. For that, we'll continue to use diesel drive systems. And Daimler Trucks has got the most efficient trucks in the market in this area. That applies to Mercedes-Benz trucks as well as Freightliner and Fuso. In a minute, Stefan Buchner will tell you more about what we will do at Mercedes-Benz Trucks. And when it comes to connectivity, we also want to speed up. And to be able to do that, we need a smart platform management. We have progressed quite a bit, more so than any competitor. In the entire triad, we have successfully rolled out heavy-duty engines, and now we are tackling medium-duty engines. And that makes us the only manufacturer with a globally available integrated drivetrain. And later on, you can take a look at it straight away right here in this hall. The chassis for heavy-duty trucks are also used across brands in the Mercedes-Benz Actros and in our brand-new Freightliner Cascadia. Next up, our electronics architecture. It's used in Mercedes-Benz as well as in the new heavy-duty trucks from Freightliner and Fuso. It enables us to quickly roll out electronic components that enhance safety or networking in all markets, such as, for example, our truck data center. Ladies and gentlemen, this box is the basis for all of Daimler Truck's connectivity services. Every byte the truck receives or sends goes over this box, over this truck data center. Applications such as Fleetboard and Detroit Connect access it. And the same goes for all the other connectivity services we are developing. Thank you. In sum, we are really making good progress with our platforms. We can take the local needs of our customers into account. At the same time, we benefit from significant economies of scale. By 2020, as early as that, this implementation will be complete. That will give us a unique position in our industry. None of our competitors will be able to do the same until 2020. Well, in a minute, Stefan Buchner will show you what's possible today with our platforms. And I'm certain Mercedes-Benz Trucks will this year once again set new benchmarks for efficiency, security, networking and efficiency. Stefan, the stage is yours.
Thank you, Wolfgang.
Thank you, Wolfgang. Ladies and gentlemen, for Mercedes-Benz Trucks 2016 is a very special year. We celebrate 120 years of the truck. We celebrate 20 years of our Actros. And here, today, we'll show you how we'll bring our industry forward into the future. We've developed numerous innovations for more efficiency, safety and connectivity. Because those are the issues that are most important to our customers. I'll briefly introduce you to the most important of them. First, our trucks will use even less fuel in the future. To that end, we've optimized the engine yet again. Important innovations to fuel injection and turbocharging that we introduced in 2015 in our 12.8-liter engine are now also available in our 10.7-liter engine. We improved the powertrains for both engines once again, as well as the aerodynamics of our trucks. Together with the 2015 changes, the Actros now consumes up to 6% less diesel. In comparison to its 2011 predecessor, it's even 15% less. Second, our Mercedes-Benz trucks are from now on even safer. And that's thanks to our new assist systems. We are bringing sideguard assist to market, the world's first manufacturer to do so on this planet. With it, Mercedes-Benz trucks can warn their drivers of pedestrians, bike riders and obstacles. This is a huge step forward in active safety. Our Active Brake Assist 4 is also a world first, an emergency brake assistance system that can also recognize pedestrians. My third topic today is connectivity. With it, things will be possible that our industry has long dreamt of. Take Mercedes-Benz Uptime, for example. This new service minimizes downtime and increases operating time. Now, how does it work? Mercedes-Benz Uptime analyzes real-time data from the entire Mercedes-Benz Truck Center. This enables us to detect maintenance and repair needs early and to support our customers in three respects. They will be informed of minor maintenance issues, such as, for example, the consistently low air pressure, and can address them themselves. Required repair facility appointments will be optimally planned, namely, maintenance and repair work can be bundled. Necessary replacement or spare parts can be ordered in advance, and the dates and times for service matched with the customer's route scheduling. Our Mercedes-Benz truck can also recognize acute technical problems while operating and give early notification to the customer and repair facility, thus we can avoid a potential breakdown. As you can see, Mercedes-Benz uptime significantly increases fleet performance. The technical basis is our truck data center that Wolfgang Bernhard just presented to you. With this piece of hardware, our customers also have access to something else new at the IAA, the free Fleet Board Manager app. It delivers our customers information on the weekly use of their fleets, details on fuel consumption, and much more. Also new, our Fleetboard Store. It ensures our customers will be able to access a variety of apps from a single source that are useful for their daily work. Therefore, we have deliberately designed this store to be open. All industry partners are invited to contribute apps. Let me give you two of the latest examples. The SpaceNap app tells you how much space is still left on a trailer. To calculate the available space, you only have to take one picture of the space. Then we've got the conical heap app. Depending on the granular size of the bulk material, it informs the driver about where the conical heap will form when he unloads the bulk material. Drivers can see that in the reverse camera. Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, we have many new products and services for our customers, and they all increase the road efficiency of our trucks. This is a new term. It describes how every Mercedes-Benz truck is a highly efficient total package made up of low total costs of ownership, high safety, and a high degree of utilization. All three issues are a high priority for our customers, and that's precisely why we are moving forward with urgency yesterday, today, and in the future. Thank you.
Welcome, Hartmut Schick, Head of Division, Daimler Buses.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. There are lots of news at Daimler Buses. Therefore, I'll give you the most important facts and bullet points. As a look at the most important business numbers shows, it's going well, and that in the face of challenging markets. We are profitable. In spite of market-driven declines in sales volumes in the first half of this year, our EBIT grew by 40% compared to the previous year. And in our core markets, we built on our market leadership. We are clearly number one with a big lead on our competitors. That's not a given in the current environment. Decisive to this lead are the products that win our customers over. Vehicles that are environmentally friendly, safe, connective, and attractive to passengers. Let's talk about efficiency. We brought the Citaro NGT to market. Its CO2 emissions are up to 10% less than that of a comparable diesel vehicle. In addition, we cut the noise level in half. In safety, I have another example for you, our new LED headlights. No other bus on the road has them. Not only are they safer, but also efficient in two respects. First, they require less power. Second, halogen lights will be changed about 30 times in the life of a bus. In contrast, with LED lights, there's not a single change. My final topic, OmniPlus. Under this name, we'll offer our customers tailored services. Among them is depot management. We'll take over the maintenance work for our customers right in their repair facility. That saves them unnecessary trips, downtime, and administrative overhead. Thanks to connectivity, we can also improve telediagnostics. In case of a breakdown, the driver digitally transmits his exact position along with the error code to our service. He receives assistance, and the roadside technician or repair facility is prepared. In brief, that's our news for today. But we're also working on the transportation of tomorrow. The Mercedes-Benz Future Bus shows our next destination. A city bus that lessens the burden on the driver through autonomous driving functions is a lot of fun for its passengers and will bring us all into cities more safety, efficiency and comfort. You can see for yourself what such a feel-good bus looks like. Just visit us at our stand. I cordially invite you all to stop by for a visit. And with that, I'll turn over to Mercedes-Benz vans.
Volker Mornhinweg, head of Mercedes-Benz Vans.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. You can see for yourself that the digitization advances, and that's why we've brought along a coil of fiberglass cable. The internet is changing our world, and it's changing our van business. More and more service providers organize their logistics online, networking their company throughout the entire value-added chain. Of course, that's great news for Mercedes-Benz vans. We have the best and strongest product portfolio in the history of our company. We have a tailor-made vehicle for every use case. The Citan, for instance, is a champion of city centers. We'll be offering a dual-clutch transmission for diesel engines starting in 2017, and there are two new design packages for both interior and exterior, off-road and dynamics packages for the exterior and color and chrome package for the interior. The Vito on the left-hand side will become more versatile, featuring panoramic roofs, making it even more attractive for as a people carrier. And it's offered with three drivetrain variants: front-wheel drive, rear-wheel drive, and all-wheel drive, which is unique in this vehicle segment. And the Vito has won the German Commercial Vehicle Award prize, awarded by an expert jury of contractors. So this shows that the Vito convinces professionals. And the Sprinter stays at the top, although it has gained a few pounds. There's a new variant, 5.5 tons, that enables our customers to transport even heavier payloads. And we've increased the power of our entry-level engines. Our figures show that we are perfectly positioned in all global markets. 2015 was a record year for us, and this year is going even better. We've increased our revenues in the first half of the year by 19%, and we've increased our EBIT by 56% to 702 million euros. In total, we've sold 21% more vehicles than in the first half of 2015. And all in all, we achieved a return on sales of 11% in the first half of the year. And we've successfully continued our growth course during the summer month. But despite all that success, we don't want to rest on our laurels. We will utilize digitization for a fundamental change of our business model. We're starting our initiative for the future, Advance, and we will evolve from a manufacturer to a provider. We will enhance our business model by thinking beyond the vehicle, by offering complete transport solutions. We will become a provider of holistic systems to help to shape the value-added chain of our customers as efficiently as possible. The Advance initiative consists of three fields of action: Digital Advance, Solutions Advance, and Mobility Advance. About 2 weeks ago, we presented a number of Advance projects on the occasion of our Van Innovation Campus. Here on the IAA, we will present first products ready for the market. Number one is Vans Mobility GmbH, a newly founded company that offers solutions for fleet management and rental and sharing models. With these models, customers pay for using a vehicle and not for owning a vehicle. This company will start operation in 2017 under the umbrella of Daimler Financial Services. Novelty number two, an online platform for our customers, comprising a whole bundle of services. Our name for this approach is Mercedes Pro. This service brand will bundle a number of services starting in 2017, services that deal with the everyday work of our van customers. Everything is individual, personalized, and available 24/7 on a digital platform. Today, we will present the first module of this platform, Mercedes Pro Connect. This product gives our customers full transparency of the activities of their fleet at any time, significantly reducing the administrative overhead. There is maintenance management, electronic vehicle log books, and real-time display of vehicle status. And it's possible to put together these services individually. Connectivity enables us to provide leaner processes and cost efficiency. That much today on Mercedes Pro. Advance will also advance our vehicles. For instance, when it comes to electric mobility, we will launch a fully electric van to the market in 2018, a van that's tailored for delivery business. More powerful batteries enable us to efficiently use electric motors. And let there be no mistake, our customers won't have to compromise on performance. Our electric vans will be tailor-made for urban regions. Today, we can develop a powertrain that for certain operation profiles can compete with a combustion engine in terms of operating costs. Advance will continue to bring forth such innovations. A first taste of that is our Vision van. It features a fully automated cargo bay, integrated delivery drones, and unique communication between the vehicle and the environment. It drives locally emission-free and delivers parcels virtually noiseless. It shows what's possible, and it will be the role model of a networked and intelligent van. That way it will shape the development of the next years. Ladies and gentlemen, there's never been that much change, not just at Mercedes-Benz vans, but also in the entire industry. We want to drive that change, and we will drive it with the best innovations of our time and the strongest product portfolio of our history. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I hope we've achieved our goal. You're all awake, you're ready for the commercial vehicles IAA. There was a lot of information, very little time, and I'm sure you still have some questions. We've set aside about 5 minutes for a live Q&A session, but that will not be enough time to answer all questions, and that's why we've set up a special service for you. You can send in questions through WhatsApp until 9:30. I've seen that some of you have already made use of that service. I assure you, all questions that we receive from you until 9:30 will be answered today. Besides the WhatsApp service, there is also a press kit and a separate information kit on the many services of Mercedes-Benz Pro. Both are available in the hall here and also at the info counter at the beginning. Let's start with the Q&A session. Procedure is as usual. Raise a hand. We will bring you a microphone. And please tell us your name and company you work for. Who has the first question? Maybe too early for questions. Don't see any hands. Can't be 600 journalists and not a single question. Maybe we should have poured them more coffee this morning. Okay, if there are no questions, this one? There. That is great. Thank you. I have a question regarding electric mobility. What you're presenting here is a huge topic. Can you say something about the projected volume of vehicles you see for both vans and for the other areas? Can you say a bit about your plans? Well, of course, we'll be starting in 2018. You might remember that we launched a Vito e-cell in 2011, was also a series production vehicle. We're starting again because we believe the market is now mature for electric mobility, but forgive me, we're not going to talk about sales volume predictions. We don't want to anticipate that. But one thing is clear, this will be a series production vehicle. Well, like I said, we're not going to talk about production volumes here. Eventually, it depends on the customer. But the e-Canada will start on three continents. It's more a matter of infrastructure. The biggest barrier to selling this vehicle is the infrastructure. Once there is an infrastructure, it will be possible to deliver the vehicle, so there are no restrictions, no limitations. For city buses, buses are only procured in spot. I think that electric buses will say more widely in 2020, and we believe in 2030, 70% of city buses will be electric. At Mercedes-Benz Trucks, we believe that these vehicles will be launched in the beginning of the next decade. I'm deeply convinced that there will be demand from our customers, and of course, we will have the necessary production volumes and sell those vehicles. Thank you. We have time for one more question. My question, you've talked a lot about autonomous driving. Who drives autonomous driving? Is it trucks? Do trucks drive cars or cars trucks? You're talking about platooning. Are there maybe synergies? Can you tell us a bit about your internal organization in that respect? We are in a great position. We develop cars and use those developments in city traffic and in trucks. But this is not a competition. It's not a race. It's more about complementing each other's work. And let me be very clear. Without the progress that has been made by passenger cars, we'd never be where we are today for our trucks. This goes for autonomous driving, but it also goes for fully electric vehicles, what you see here today, of a great collaboration between the two areas of the company, helping each other and motivating each other. So we have good collaboration and we have good network. Thank you very much. And that's the end of our Q&A session. Brings us to the end of this press conference. Thank you very much. Thank you for having been our guest today. We'll continue on WhatsApp. But before you get out your smartphones and ask your questions, I would like to take the opportunity to invite you to a second press conference tomorrow morning, a press conference on the efficiency run product launch. We will have important news on CO2 reduction for you. and the photo session for that event will be at 9 o'clock. All the best to you. Enjoy your time here in Hanover on the IAA. Enjoy the day. Thank you very much.